I am Shelia Nash-Stevenson, and I'm an integration engineer for Planetary Missions Program Office here at Marshall Space Flight Center. I was born in Lawrence County, Alabama, a little town called Hillsborough, Alabama, and I attended Cortland High School, and I graduated from Austin High School. And I went on to attend Alabama A&M University. I didn't want to get too far away from home because I was only 16 when I graduated, so that was kind of my way of staying close to home. And I majored in electrical, electronic engineering technology at Alabama A&M University. I had a physics professor that felt that I was a really, really good student, and he wanted me to come back and enter into a physics program that he had started that year that I graduated. And I was one of his first students to enter into the master's degree program in physics, and the first person to graduate from that program. I was hesitating when he asked me to come into that program because I took physics in high school and I took it again in college, and it was not the easiest subject for me. So when he asked me to come back and get my degree in a graduate degree in physics, it was kind of scary, but I had some folk that I respected very well that thought I could do it, and I said, okay, I will, and he was going to get me money. So he was giving me money to come back to school. I was only 19 at that time, so I still didn't want to leave home, didn't want to leave mom and dad, so I said, oh, okay, this may be a good way to stay close. So I accepted the fellowship, which was a NASA fellowship, and for 2 years I studied and got my master's degree in physics. And a couple of years later, after I had gotten married and had become a full-time employee, he started the PhD program in physics at Alabama A&M University and wanted me to come back again to maybe just take a course. You know, we needed to have students. If we had a program, we needed students. So since he was my mentor and had helped me along the way, I felt that, you know, I can help the program out by attending a class or two. But once I started in the program, it was very hard for me not to complete the program. I don't necessarily believe in starting things I don't finish. So I had to finish. But also, I was married, and I had to start my family because I was getting old. So I had a coworker of mine that was a male that told me I would never be able to go to school, have children, and work full time, and get a degree in physics, get a PhD in physics. And I'm like, the one thing I don't like is for somebody to tell me what I can and cannot do. So I'll just have to show you. So that was one of the things that really encouraged me to go ahead and finish that program. So I did get a PhD in physics. It took me a few years because I gave birth to 2 children in the process. The first child, I think I stayed out maybe a year. And the second child, I stayed out a semester. Enough for him to be born and to kind of get used to it. But I was still working full time, and I was just taking like a course, a semester. And eventually, I did complete that program. So I'm very happy that I did. It has really opened a lot of doors for me. Okay, so I guess one of the very first mentors I had was the physics professor. His name was M.C. George, Dr. M.C. George. I was always impressed with him because he taught the undergraduate physics programs, physics courses. the very first two, I believe, that I took. And he would walk into the classroom with only a piece of chalk, and he would start writing on the board. He didn't have a book at all. And everything he wrote on that board was exactly what was in the book. And I was always amazed at how he could remember all that information without having the book there with him. And he was a really good professor. And he noticed the potential in his students, and he always encouraged us to do more. And I always got good grades because he was a good teacher. So when he asked me to come back to school, you know, I trusted him, but I still needed a little bit more reinforcement. So I had other advisors, other teachers that I had been in their classes, and they also encouraged me to do that also. But Dr. George was the main person that really got me involved in doing things, and he was always supportive. Once I graduated, he had he knew of a job opportunity, and he said, "I want you to go and interview for this job," and that was one of the first jobs I got after I graduated with my master's, and that led to even more opportunities. So he really did. He always kept up with what I was doing. In fact, he's probably about 80. He's in his late 80s now. And one day, maybe last year, I got a post on Facebook, which I never really go to, but I saw that he had put a post out there. He had seen something about me, and he commented on it. And I did send a comment back, but I'm not sure that he responded. He may have had some of his grandchildren to do it, but I was really surprised that he even now still keeps up with what we're doing. I had a NASA research fellowship for my master's degree program, and that brought me to Marshall the first time as a graduate student. And I would come out during, it was sometimes throughout the year I would come out a few hours a day or a few hours a week to work with Dr. Tom Parnell and Dr. Jerry Fishman. And I think they are both retired, but we worked with them on BATSE. So I did that for the 2 years that I was in graduate school working on my master's degree program. And after that, I went to work for private industry for a while. And I was working for Hughes Aircraft, the Huntsville Engineering Center. And went to church one Sunday, and there was an announcement that Marshall was looking for engineers. I'm not sure how the process went, but you filled out applications. And what was happening at that time at Marshall is that their diversity numbers were not where they wanted to be, so they were looking for some good candidates to kind of more diversify their population. And I filled out the application, and I interviewed, I think, with two areas, at least two, maybe three, and decided to go and work with the instrumentations group in the avionics lab at that time, and stayed there for maybe about almost 10 years. I started a NASA Administrators Fellowship around 2000. Actually, it was 98 to 2000. And when I completed that fellowship, I went to be the University Affairs Officer. And I stayed there for about 3 years. And then I went back to engineering because I started in engineering when I was doing instrumentation. Excuse me, and went back to engineering as a liaison between the Flight Projects Directorate and the Engineering Directorate. And then we started a series of reorgs and ended up with in Spacecraft and Vehicle Systems Group. And after that, I did a ninth floor detail with Robert and Robin, which was a lot of fun. That was a lot of fun. And then when I finished that detail, I went on to the Planetary Missions Program Group, which used to be Discovery New Frontiers and Lunar Quest, and now it's Planetary Missions Program Office. Okay, I just this weekend finished a series of interviews relative to the Hidden Figures movie, and they asked us about what we wanted this movie what message did we want folk to get out of this movie. And the main thing I wanted is for our young girls to see the movie, especially our young African-American girls, to see this movie and get inspired to tackle those hard, and really they're not hard, it's just people have said they're hard. But I wanted them to be inspired to go on and take those math and science courses to realize that they really are fun and to realize that they are really capable of doing this type of work. And hopefully they will go on and get degrees in the STEM fields, science, technology, engineering, math fields, and then come back to Marshall and help us on our journey to Mars. So if that movie can portray that message to those girls, it would be way more than worth anything that anybody has invested into the movie. Because that's what we need. Our girls see so many things now that takes them in different directions that are not always necessarily positive. And sometimes it can cause them to have a negative image of themselves because they don't look like what they see. But this movie will help them to see that all they need to do is use their brains. And they can go farther than anything else can take them. So hopefully this is what happens with this movie. And the way that we get them and encourage them is to show them that, yes, somebody that looks just like you has gone there, has been there. Somebody just like you has already done this. So it's easy for you to do it also. Believe in yourself, apply yourself, prepare yourself, and you too can excel just like they did. And that's what we do. And we have to reach them where they are and bring them up to where we want them to be. One of the things that I believe Marshall can do is to find some people that are really interested in seeing the young folk grow and excel. It's more than just saying I want to be a mentor. It's really meaning that. And when you're really a good mentor, you're going to sit there and you're going to talk to that mentee. And you're going to let them know the things that they need to do to be successful. And you're going to be there for them when they become discouraged. And you're going to encourage them. And then you will seek out opportunities for them because you know the potential that they have. And when an opportunity becomes available, you make sure that they have everything they need to take advantage of that opportunity. And you know what they need, you know the environment. So it's up to us to help them to get to where they need to be and be open-minded enough to look beyond the color of their skin or their gender or their sexual orientation, whatever it may be, and help them to excel. I remember a time when I had just gotten my PhD and I was given an assignment that I thought was a little bit less of a challenge than I wanted it to be. And I was a little discouraged. And I gave a call to a person that was mentoring me at that time, and that was Dr. Julian Earls. He was at the Glenn Research Center. And I talked to him, and he gave me words to say. To use when I talked to my supervisor about that particular assignment. And he had a very good way of saying things. And I didn't do as good of a job as he did when he explained it to me, but I did a good enough job that I didn't have to do that particular assignment. So I was very thankful to him for that. And to this day, when I see him, he always remembers that I'm still here, and he always checks to see, where are you now? And is there anything I can do to help? So that to me was a great mentor.